In Aeronautica Imperialis, pilots scramble to their planes to dogfight with the enemy and claim aerial supremacy in the skies of the 41st millennium. In this video, we're going to show you exactly how to paint your planes for Aeronautica Imperialis up to battle-ready standard. We're going to look at the planes of the Imperial Navy, Orc Airwar, Tau Aircast, and of course the Astra Militarum 2, and we use tips and tricks so you can get your planes off the runway and into the skies, defeating the enemy as quickly as possible. Now, to prepare our models for painting, we've already undercoated them here with various undercoat sprays. The Imperial Thunderbolt's been undercoated with Mechanicus Standard Grey Spray. The Orc Fighter Bomber has been undercoated with Mephiston Red. The Tau Barracuda has been undercoated with McCrag Blue Spray. And the Astra Militarum Valkyrie has been undercoated with Zandri Dust. You'll also notice we've actually left a couple of bits off the models here. The bombs and rockets under the wings of the Thunderbolt and the Fighter have been left on the sprue separately, so we can paint those a bit more easily. We've undercoated the Orc Fighter Bomber's sprue with Lead Belcher, and the rockets and bombs for the Thunderbolt Fighter with Mechanicus Standard Grey Spray. You'll also notice we've mounted our aircraft specially for painting. What we've done here is we've taken some of the spare flying stands you get with your Aeronautica Imperialis boxes, mounted them to a spare Citadel base, and then put the plane on top of it ready for painting. This means you can spray and paint your model on this spare base, and then when it's done, you can transfer it over to the gaming base, ready for you to take to the skies. That also means your spare painting base is ready for future use as well. Now, the first plane we're going to look at is that stalwart of the Imperial Navy. It's the Thunderbolt Fighter. Now, remember for this, we've already undercoated it here with Mechanicus Standard Grey Spray. And the first thing we're going to do is apply Iron Hand Steel to the metallic part of the miniature. And for this, we're going to be using our small base brush. Let's get to it. So first of all, let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here and add it to our palette like so. Add just a touch of water here as well, just to thin it down just a little bit, but not too much for metallic paint. Perfect. Then, onto our Thunderbolt. We're going to be painting this very carefully all over the metallic areas of the miniature. So look out for the guns, the engine housing, anything that's going to be metal, the jet engines as well. Have a good look around the model. Make sure you're picking out all the metal bits here, including everything at the back here as well, the big jet bits too. Take your time to make sure you're picking out all the bits you want to be metal. Try and be as neat as you possibly can here. Try not to hit the base coat of Mechanicus Standard Grey on the armour of the Thunderbolt Fighter. But if you do, it's not the end of the world. You can always go back later on and touch it up with Mechanicus Standard Grey in a pot. And there we go, the Iron Hand Steel is all over the metallic areas of our Thunderbolt Fighter. Alright, up next is at the next paint, and for this we're using a contrast paint, Basilicanum Grey, which we're going to apply all over the entire model. This will help shade the grey areas and also the metallic areas too. For this we're using our medium shade brush, so let's get to it. Now the Basilicanum Grey, we're going to take it out of the pot here and add it to our palette like this. We're not going to be thinning this down, we're just going to make sure we're not overloading the brush with too much paint. There we go, that's perfect. Then, onto our Thunderbolt Fighter. We're going to be very carefully applying this all over the miniature, like so. You want a nice thick coat all over the model, like so. But as you're going, make sure it's not pooling together in any of the large areas, such as the wings. In fact, there's a nice trick you can do on the wings here. You can just use the brush here to just streak the paint back, like so, just to make it look like there's sort of streaky bits going back, almost like weathering, essentially, for the wings here. And that'll dry nicely. Cool. So do that all over the entire model, both the metallics and the grey. And once that's done, we'll move on to the next stage. So there we go, that's the Basilicanum Grey dried on our Thunderbolt, and it's looking pretty good. So next up, we're going to be adding a couple more colours to our miniature, notably on the tail fin and the windows, and for both of these, we're going to be using contrast paints. But before we apply those, we need to apply Grey Sear first as a base coat. So grab your medium layer brush, and let's get to it. Let's take a bit of Grey Sear here from the pot, add it to our palette like so. We're going to be thinning it down just a touch to help it flow onto the model a little easier. Then, onto our Thunderbolt miniature. I'm just going to be painting this very carefully onto the tail fin here, and the windows as well. Now, especially when it comes to the windows, be as neat as you possibly can. You're desperately trying not to make any mistakes there, so just make sure you're using a nice thin brush and a steady hand when it comes to the windows. Here we go. Just going to pick those out very carefully. There we go. Be as neat as you can here. With the grey sear added to the windows and the tail fin, it's time to move on to the contrast paints. So for this we're going to be using Iandan Yellow on the tail fin, and on the windows we'll use Ethematic Blue. First of all, the Iandan Yellow, and for this we're using our medium shade brush again. So again, let's take a bit of paint from the pot like so, and onto our palette, we're just making sure we're not overloading the brush here. Then onto our tail fin on the Thunderbolt, we're going to very carefully paint it just like this, going down in line with the tail fin like so, just making sure we're giving a nice even coat of Iandan Yellow to the tail fin like this. Making sure you're avoiding any pooling, just making sure you're moving that paint around to give a nice even coat. Try and avoid the grey there, and just flip it around and do the same on the same other side. Then onto the windows, we're adding Ethematic Blue, and for this we're using our medium layer brush for a bit more added control. So there we go, the contrast paints are done, giving a really nice flash of colour to our Thunderbolt fighter. Let's add a bit more colour to the model now as well, as we're going to add some dark metal in. Here we're going to be using Balthazar Gold to pick out some areas of metal, after which we're going to wash it with Agrax Earthshade. We're also going to use that Agrax Earthshade to apply some shades into the recesses of our plane as well, but more on that later. First of all, it's that base coat of Balthazar Gold, and for this we're using our medium layer brush. So let's take a bit of paint from the pot as always here. We're going to take a little bit of water, thin it down just a touch. Okay, that's about right. Maybe a bit more. Boom, that's perfect. Then, onto our Thunderbolt. It's going to be adding it to certain areas. Now, this is entirely up to your taste where you're going to add it. For me, I'm going to put it onto the engine intakes, as the ones on the front of the box have the same colour engine intakes here. We're also going to be applying it to the barrels of the las cannon here. The gun flashes at the end, like so. Anywhere else you want in your miniature, maybe just a touch up here as well, just a nice bit of colour here in the middle of our Thunderbolt. Basically, anywhere you like on your model, it's entirely up to you. Do it to taste. With the Balthazar Gold applied, we're now going to apply a wash of Agrax Earthshade over the top of it very carefully here, again using our medium layer brush. Once that's done, we're also going to use the Agrax Earthshade in a different way. Again, with the medium layer brush, we're going to be very carefully applying it into the recesses of the plane itself. So using very carefully, just dragging it across the recesses here. This is to make it look a bit weathered, a bit beaten up, add a bit more colour to the grey of the plane as well. So there we go, with that wash applied, our plane is almost done. Of course, we still have to paint the missiles and bombs that attach underneath our Thunderbolt's wings. And remember, we are painting these separately on the sprue, and we've undercoated it with Mechanicus Standard Grey. Once that's dry, we're going to be applying a Basilicon and Grey contrast paint all over the missiles and bombs. Then we're going to be applying Black Templar to just the missile parts and just the bomb parts themselves. And then finally, we're going to use Corn Red to pick out the missile tips. First of all, it's that Basilicon and Grey, and for this, we're going to be using our medium shade brush. Let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here, like so. Again, just make sure we're not overloading our brush. Then, onto the sprue. Here we go. Now, for this, we're going to be picking out these missiles at the top here, like this. Make sure painting them both sides. And we're also going to pick out these wing bombs here as well. Then we're using Black Templar to pick out just the bomb parts themselves here, leaving the parts that are attached to the plane, the Basilicon and Grey, so picking out the bombs here. Again, we're just painting the missiles here with Black Templar, leaving the grey bits where they attach to the plane. Then with a medium layer brush, we're going to pick out the tips of the missiles here with Corn Red. So there we go, that's our missiles and wing bombs painted. All that remains now is to take them off of the sprue very carefully, attach them to our Thunderbolt fighter, and then take the Thunderbolt and put it onto its gaming base. And there we go, with the bombs and missiles attached under the wings, and the plane attached to its gaming base, our Thunderbolt is ready for the skies. Alright, up next let's have a look at painting the red craft of the Orc Airwar, and for this we're going to be painting a fighter bomber. Now our fighter bomber has already been undercoated here with Mephiston Red Spray, and the first thing we're going to do is pick out the metallics with Lead Belcher paint. For this we're using our small base brush, so let's get to it. Let's take a bit of paint from the pot here, add it to our palette. Now here we're going to add a little bit of water, but not too much, just a little bit. There we go, perfect. Then, onto the fighter bomber. Very carefully, we're going to be picking out all the metallic areas of the miniature, so look for the engines here, the guns, all the metallic parts of the miniature you want to be metal, pick those out with Lead Belcher here. Now, over a red undercoat like this, you may need to get a couple of coats on to get a nice solid colour, but don't worry, that's absolutely fine. And try as hard as you can not to make a mistake, but don't worry, if you do, you can always go back and hit the red areas again with Mephiston Red paint out of a pot. So, there we go, that's the Lead Belcher painted onto the silver areas of our fighter bomber. Alright, up next let's add a few more colours into the mix. First of all, let's add some dark metal areas with Balthazar Gold. Then we're going to pick out some black panels on the fighter bomber with Corvus Black. And finally we'll wash the entire model with Agrax Earthshade. But first of all, that Balthazar Gold, and for this we're using our medium layer brush. So let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here, add it to our palette. Again, touch of water but not too much, just to thin it down a little bit. Perfect. Then, onto our fighter bomber. Here we're going to be picking out areas of metallics that we want to be darker. So, for example, I'm going to break up the engine bay here with a little bit of dark metal going on here as well. Perhaps you want to pick out some panels, such as these. Now, this is entirely to taste, and it's really just to break up the colours on your miniature. So do these wherever you want them to be. Just break up that silver here with some darker metal. Next up, we're doing the same again, this time with Corvus Black, again using a medium layer brush. Here we're just going to pick out random panels all over our Orc fighter bomber, not really keeping it uniformed because that wouldn't be very Orc-y. So just pick these out wherever you want to, it's entirely to taste. We're going to pick out the front of the wings here, a few other panels around as well. Once you're happy with what you've got, we'll move on to the next stage. Now I've applied those base coats all over our miniature, it's time to wash the entire fighter bomber with Agrax Earthshade. Here we've switched over to our medium shade brush, and we're just going to be applying it nice and evenly all over the entire model like so. Now don't worry about too much paint you're putting on here, just make sure you're moving around and avoiding it pooling in any areas, especially on the large flat surfaces like the wings. So make sure you're moving that paint around and stop it gathering like this. There we go, that's the Agrax Earthshade Wash applied to our fighter bomber, and it's looking pretty good. But let's add a splash of more colour to our miniature here by adding some contrast paints in. But before we do that, we're going to have to apply Grey Sear base coats to those parts of the miniature we want to apply contrast paints to. Now we're going to be putting on white panels, yellow panels, and of course the windows too. So to all of those areas, we're going to be applying Grey Sear with our medium layer brush. Let's get to it. Again, take a little bit of paint from the pot here, and onto our palette. Just a touch of water here. Help thin that paint down, makes it go on the model a little bit easier as well. Then, onto our miniature, we're going to be applying this to anywhere we want to be white or yellow, or indeed the windows. So just pick out those, very careful, pick out these parts here, like this, for example. On the windows here, we're going to be picking those out here with Grey Sear too. And just very, very carefully pick out the parts of the model you want to be either yellow, white, or indeed window panes. So there we go, that's Grey Sear applied onto the panels we want to be white, those we want to be yellow, and also the windows as well. So now it's time for the contrast paints. Up first, we're going to be using Iandan Yellow, which we're going to place onto those panels we want to be yellow. Then we use Apothecary White onto the white panels on the teeth on the front of our plane. And then we're going to use Ephematic Blue to pick out the windows. For all of these, we're using our medium layer brush. So first of all, with the Iandan Yellow, let's take a bit of paint from the pot again onto our palette. Here, we're just making sure we're not overloading our brush at all. We're not going to be thinning this down, just making sure there's not too much paint on the brush. And that's perfect. So then, onto the miniature. Here, we're going to be picking out random panels we want to be yellow. So for example, I'm going to pick this panel here, up here. Anywhere you want to be yellow, pick this out with the Iron Yellow. Remember, these are orc planes, so you don't have to be neat or indeed symmetrical with your patches. I'll pick out whichever ones I want to be yellow, then we'll move on to the white stage. Next up, we're picking out the white areas with Apothecary White. Again, we're using a medium layer brush here just for added control. Just very carefully pick out those white areas here with this contrast paint. And the last contrast paint is Ethematic Blue, which we're very carefully applying to the windows of both the cockpit and the turret gun as well. Here, be as careful as you possibly can not to hit any part of the model that you've already painted. Just very carefully putting that Ethematic Blue into the windows there. So there we go, with the windows painted in with Ethematic Blue, that's our plane almost ready to take to the skies. There's only one thing left to do here, and that's to paint the bombs and rockets that go under our fighter bomber's wings. Now, earlier on, we've already sprayed them with Lead Belcher spray while still on the sprue, which makes them a little bit easier to paint. What we're going to do here is add a couple of base coats in. First of all, Mephiston Red, and then Grey Sear, just to pick out various parts of the bombs, and then we're going to wash the bombs with Agrax Earthshade. So, let's have a look with that Mephiston Red first of all. For this, we're using our medium layer brush. Take a little bit of paint from the pot here, and then onto our palette here again. We're going to wash it down just a touch, not too much. Then, onto the sprue. What we're going to do is we're painting the two sets of bombs here, this one here and that one there. So we're going to start off by just picking out certain bits here. Now, again, these are orcies, so there's no reason you need to be uniformed or symmetrical. You can just pick out any bits you like at all. I'm going to paint the front of these bombs here and then the tip of these bombs here. It's completely and utterly up to you. All right, next up, we're picking out some parts with Grey Sear. Here I'm picking out the teeth on these bombs over here. And then also I'm going to pick out the panels over here as well, again, to taste, whichever parts you want to pick out. Once those base coats have been applied, it's time to wash the entire bomb here, or rocket, with Agrax Earthshade. It's a nice thick coat here of Agrax Earthshade. Apply it on like so. Just make sure you're avoiding pooling here in the recesses, such as there. So, there we go. With the wash dried, our bombs are complete. All that remains is to very carefully clip them off of the sprue, attach them to our fighter bomber's wings, and take our fighter bomber and place it onto its gaming base. So with the bombs done, our fighter bomber is armed and dangerous and ready to take down some pesky Umis. Okay, so let's have a look at the planes of the Tau Empire, and specifically that blue colour scheme seen on the front cover of the Aeronautica Imperialis boxes. Now for this, we've already undercoated our model here with Macragge Blue Spray. And once that's dry, we're going to be applying a base coat of Hoth Blue, but in a kind of special way. We're going to be stippling it on with a small dry brush, and here's how we're going to do it. Take a bit of Hoth Blue from the pot like so, and then just wipe most of it off onto the palette like this. Not all of it, just most of it, like so. Perfect. Then, onto the miniature. Here's how we're going to do it. We're going to be stabbing at the miniature, like so, from above, in random spots, like this. Now what you're looking for here is a nice sort of random effect with a nice soft edge to the spots. Don't make it too uniform, just in any areas you like, but just make sure it's nice and random all over the model like so. You can do it in stripes if you like to, or in random spots. It's entirely up to you how you're going to do it. But once that's done, we'll move on to the next stage. So there we go, that's the random patches done with the hot blue, and it's already looking pretty good. Let's do the same again, this time using Fenrisian Grey to add a bit more colour to our miniature. Again, grab your small dry brush. So let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here, and onto our tissue paper again, rubbing most of it off here. Not all of it, just most of it, like so. Brilliant. Then, onto our Barracuda. I'm going to be very carefully stippling this on, and again, we're doing the inside, the ones we've already done. So just very carefully stabbing away here with the stipple brush. And again, try and make it look random here, so random patches, just knocking around all over the miniature. And not too strong a colour as well, so just try and get nice soft edges to these colours. So there we go, that's the stippling effect done on our Barracuda, and it's time for the next stage. Up next, we're going to be painting a contrast paint all over our Barracuda. We're going to use Griff Charger Grey for this. This will do two things. First of all, it'll act like a glaze, blending the colours we've already put down together, but also we'll add contrast into the recesses, helping to shade the miniature. For this, we're using our medium shade brush. Let's take a bit of Griff Charger Grey from the pot here and add it to our palette. Now, we're not thinning this down at all, just making sure we're not overloading the brush with too much paint. Perfect. Then, onto the miniature, a nice, healthy coat of Griff Charger Grey all over the entire Barracuda like so. One thing I would recommend here is make sure it doesn't pull together in the recesses too much, but don't worry, Griff Charger Grey is quite a thin contrast paint, just a nice glaze all over the model is what you're looking for. So there we go, that's the Griff Charger Grey dry. You can see the colours have been nicely blended together. Alright, let's add some more colour to the miniature here. Here we're going to be using Black Templar contrast paint to pick out the black areas of the miniature, such as the panels, the weapons, the window and the icon on top of the tower plane. For this we're using our medium shade brush. So let's take a bit of Black Templar from the pot here and onto our palette. Again, we're not going to thin this down. We're going to be using it straight from the pot, just making sure we're not overloading our brush. Perfect. Then, onto our Barracuda. Let's pick out those parts of the miniature we want to be black here. So we're going to be picking out these black panels here, and the vents, the weapons, the ring around the top of the drones there, also the window and the tower icon on top. Basically, this is entirely to your taste. You'll notice as well, as we're going over a darker colour here, you might need a couple of coats of Black Templar to get a really solid colour. Not a problem, let the first one dry and apply the second one afterwards. So there we go, that's the black panels done and the weapons and the window, all painted with Black Templar as well. We've also painted the engines at the back in Black Templar too. Alright, up next, let's add a bit more colour to our miniature. Here we're going to add some white panels in. We're going to start off with a base coat of Grey Sear, and after that's applied, we'll apply Apothecary White contrast paint over the top of it. For both of these, we're using our medium layer brush. Let's add a bit of paint from the pot here, add it to our palette. Touch of water here, just to thin it down. And let's get onto our Barracuda. So here, we'll be applying these anywhere we want, really, but this is to taste. You don't want too much white on the miniature to take away from the colour here, but just the odd panel here and there, just to break up that blue colour a little bit. Once you've painted in those sections, carefully apply a layer of contrast apothecary white over the top of those bits. And once that's done and dry, we'll attach this model to its gaming base. So there we go, our Tau Barracuda is done and ready to take to the skies. Alright, up last let's have a look at the Astra Militarum, and for this we'll be painting a Valkyrie Assault Carrier. Now we've already undercoated our model here with Xandri Dust Spray, and the first thing we're going to be doing is applying a base coat of Castellan Green over the top. We're going to be using that special stippling technique again to create a sort of camouflage pattern on top. For this we're using our small dry brush, so let's get to it. Take a bit of paint from the pot here, and we've got a bit of tissue paper here ready. I'm going to just rub off most of the paint from the brush onto our tissue paper here. Not all of it, but most of it. There we go, perfect. Then, onto our Valkyrie. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to use a sort of stabbing motion here to create a sort of camouflage pattern across the miniature. Now we're going to be sort of stabbing it quite loosely like this to create some nice soft edges around the camouflage pattern. I'm going to be going in lines over the miniature like so. There we go, just create a sort of like lined pattern here using the stipple pattern. Do it all over the Valkyrie, and once that's done, it's time to move on to the next stage. So there we go, we've used Castellan Green to create a sort of rough camo pattern on the top of our Valkyrie. It's time to move on to the next stage. Up next, we're going to be painting the metallics of our Valkyrie, so the gun and the feet and various parts of the miniature, using Iron Hand Steel. Now for this, we're going to be painting it with a small base brush. Let's grab our Iron Hand Steel from the pot here, a little bit onto the palette like so, and a little bit of water here just to thin it down just a little bit. There we go, that's perfect. Then, onto the miniature. Let's paint the metallic areas with this colour. We're going to start off here, of course, with the engine housings at the top, the big engines at the very top of our Valkyrie. We're also going to paint the weapons at the front, the sort of metallic feet underneath the wings as well. Anything that's metallic, paint it now with Iron Hand Steel. So there we go, that's the metallics painted in. You can see we've done the engines, the weapons, the feet, and other various parts of the miniature as well. Alright, up next let's start to darken that model down again by adding a shade of Agrax Earthshade all over the entire miniature. This will shade the metallics and the fuselage of the plane as well, so with this we're using our medium shade brush. Take a little bit of paint from the pot here onto our palette like so. A little bit more like that. Now here we are going to thin this down a little bit. Just a touch of water here, just so it's not quite strong on the miniature. There we go. Then, onto the model. Let's apply a nice even coat of Agrax Earthshade all over the entire model. So here, onto the fuselage, the metal, everything, literally the entire model with Agrax Earthshade. Now be very careful as you're applying this to make sure it doesn't pull together in the recesses and on the larger flat areas as well, to make sure you're moving that paint around to make sure it's a nice even coat all over the miniature. So there we go, the Agrax Earthshade has dried, which has really nicely blended the colours together on the camouflage and also shaded all the recesses too. Up next, let's add another wash onto the model, this time non-oil, this time only going onto the metallic areas such as the engines. We want those engines to look really filthy and dirty, and non-oil is the answer for that. For this, we're using our medium shade brush. Again, let's take a bit of paint from the pot here and onto our palette. This time, we're not thinning it down, we're just going to be using it straight from the pot, but we're making sure we're not overloading our brush with too much paint. Then, onto the miniature, let's apply non-oil very carefully onto the engine housings and the other metallic parts of our Valkyrie here. Make sure you're not hitting any other part of the model, be as careful as you possibly can. Don't worry if you do make a mistake, it'll just make it look really filthy. Now once this first stage of non oil has dried, we're going to go back with a second coat of non oil, applying it just to the very end of the engines here to make it look like they're blackened from heavy use. There we go, that's the metallics done, and they're looking pretty good. Alright, let's add some more colour to our miniature with a few contrast paints. But before we do that, we're going to add Corax White onto the eagles, the windows, the missile tips, the lenses, and one of the armour panels at the back. Once that's done, we'll apply Apothecary White to the eagle and the armour panels, Athematic Blue onto the windows, and finally Blood Angels Red to apply onto the missile tips and the lenses. First of all, it's time for that Corax White though. For this, we're using our small layer brush as we want lots of control. So let's take a look at that paint from the pot here and onto our palette. We're not going to thin this down as it's quite a thin paint anyway. There we go. Then onto our miniature. Let's paint it onto the relevant areas. So what we're doing is we're picking out the armour panel at the back here, which we're going to be painting white, and the windows, the missile tips, the lenses, and the eagle that appears on the front of the model as well. Now the base coat's down, let's add some contrast paints in. First of all, Apothecary White is going to go onto the eagle here at the front of our Valkyrie and onto the armour panels at the back here as well. Then it's Athematic Blue being painted onto the windows of our Valkyrie. Try and be as careful as you possibly can here, which is why I'm using a small layer brush. With the windows done, up next we're going to be painting the missile tips and various lenses around the model here with Blood Angels Red contrast paint. We're using a small airbrush here for extra control. Be as neat as you possibly can here, try not to hit any other part of the model. And once this part's done, we're going to attach our Valkyrie to its gaming base. And that's how you can paint the miniatures from your Aeronautica Imperialis collection up to battle-ready standard really quickly and easily. Hope you enjoyed the video. Happy painting!